Good morning, VPs and all student managers. Mr. A.K. Munjal, VP HR, Maruti Suzuki. A human resource leader with diverse industry experience, telecom, manufacturing, and service, and now with a leading auto OEM with more than 7 years in manufacturing and consumer industry. He possesses a collaborative and developmental leadership style. He has been able to make HR impact in complex business environment because of the professional acumen and patience honed over the years. While confronted with initial business issues, natural approach is to get to the fundamentals and execute solutions with optimum short-term and long-term balance. He is sensitive to people and their needs and derives joy by enabling other progress in their journey of self-discovery and professional actualization. He has been able to influence and shape people, culture, and business systems through a collaborative approach in the spirit of creating relevant, simple, and sustainable solutions. His goal is to support each person he touches on his journey to become a better professional and, more importantly, a human being. His specialties are strategic HR, change management, leadership, organizational transformation, talent management, coaching, training, employee engagement, and CSR initiatives leveraging the technology of HR. His work experiences are, he started with Indo Rama Synthetics as deputy manager in July 1986. Then he got promoted to senior manager HR at Indo Rama Synthetics. Then in January 1988, he joined as head HR at Avaya Global Connect Limited, world leader in IP telephony. Then he became the HR at Sham Telecom. Now he recently is working with Maruti Suzuki since June 2007. So welcome, sir.
Leaders and know all the practical things that are going on here in the world, outside world.
Outside world. Okay, thank you. The second thing, what? Do you want to be successful?
Yes, sir.
Are you sure?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Have you ever, I'm not going to ask you anything, just think within yourself, have you ever defined your success? And if not, write it down on a piece of paper and try to look into that paper every day. And you can modify that paper also. But till you don't write what your success means to you, probably you will be on the wrong path. And I'll give you the reason. And the third thing which I always tell you the people is, the moment you ask questions to the students, there are very few people, few students who answer them, right or wrong, in the class. I'll give you the reason behind it. Before I come down to the main topic of the day, the way we have developed in our own families, we are made to think in a particular way. If you score well, you are given a positive stimulus that yes, you are doing great. If you are not doing great and your neighbor's son is doing great, then it's more terrible. Because every day, you have to see his face or your parents will be telling you that, look at that student, look at that boy, look at, and you are made to think that you are a mediocre. And when you reach to the college or schools, there are only 4 or 5, 7 students within the class which will answer those. And 90% of the students know the answer. But they don't reply it. And they are made to think that they are mediocres and those 5 people are the best people. And the way it evolves throughout your career, you develop a feeling of mediocrity and you start thinking that you are a mediocre because you come from a, you didn't score well or you're not passed out from an institute or all your friends and your neighbors or your parents have been telling you that you're a mediocre person. But let me tell you, stop thinking it. Stop thinking it. Whatever has happened, has happened. Once you go out of this college, you're a unique person within yourself. And that's the belief system. Till you don't develop that belief system, whatever the learnings you have within yourself, it will not take you anywhere. So develop that self-belief system, confidence within yourself, only things will happen. And till you don't do that, you may not be able to achieve what you are looking for, the success. Last but before I start with, for any building, a skyscraper, what is the most important thing into the building?
Foundations.
Base.
Foundation. And I appreciate that you people understand that. And let me tell you why I'm saying to you. The more the rise, the building will go up, the how strong it will depend on the foundation. And the foundation has to be laid down if it is not laid down still. If you are not strong in your foundations, and what does it mean basically? What is foundation? It's your personal value system. You may be able to learn a lot of competency, what the recruitment skill, what the talent, what's going into the market, and what's happening in the world. You come to know through the various media, social media, you come to Google and also so many things. But these fundamentals you'll never be able to evolve. And if you don't evolve these fundamentals, you'll not be able to have a risk-taking capability. You'll not be able to take a decision. You'll not be able to move forward in your career because you're not taking a risk. You'll not be able to be forward-looking. So first of all, you need to understand, and let me tell you before I start this, one of the mantras what the Japanese have. You always say that Japanese are doing great, Japanese are doing great, but Japanese are... What is that which makes them different? What makes them a different person? Okay, I think I'm getting some different types of whispers. But let me tell you, the most and most important, after working with these Japanese people, I find one word, intelligence has 2 parts. One is the knowledge, the second is the discipline. When you talk about Japanese, probably they had 10-20% of the knowledge part, and 80% is discipline. While it comes to the Indian phenomena, we have 80-90% knowledge and less than 10% discipline. And that's a hard fact. The second thing what they have developed, which I was discussing in the morning with my two of your students, and I was asking them, they don't criticize the nation. It's not that they don't have corruption, they don't have problem. The social world is much having a gray areas, more than the Indian culture. But what is that? So they never criticize the nation. And we, at all points, do not have a respect for the nation. So until and unless these are the fundamentals, why I'm telling to you before, we go to the main subject, we talk about what happens in the corporate, what the strategies are made, how the risks are taken, how the transformation takes place. But let me tell you, your whole career depends on that only. Your whole career depends on how strong you are able to lay down your foundation. And you are able to lay down on your foundation, there is no reason you will not be able to get success in your career. Okay. So now I'd like to share with you, like, there are two different worlds in the professional worlds. Why I'm saying two different worlds means one is the service industry or the IT or BFSI, and the other is the manufacturing industry. And both of these worlds are two different worlds in the sense that because the requirements are different, the people working culture is different, the skill requirements are different, the adaptability in terms of things are going to be different. But when you come, go to the service industry, go to the telecom, you go to the bank finance, where you have to deal with the external customer, the things are going to be very, very different. You require a very different skill set. And the most important skill set today is the way the digitalization is taking place. You need to be well. I think if you are an HR guy, you need to adapt to the technology. You need to understand what technology is all about. It has just in HR, it has just changed the complete view. The customer expectation or the employee expectation completely changed. So in the service industry, telecom industry, IT world, all these stuff where the service is, where you interact with a lot of people, like, the things, expectations are going to be very, very different. So you need to understand how the things work in terms of technology, because you must have seen the way the logistics have changed, the way the HR processes have changed, the way the recruitment process has changed. So you require a very different type of skill set. And most of the time it will become a more of a process oriented in the sense that solution will come automated to the, so HR has to develop a very different mindset. The first thing he has to understand that he is there to serve. HR expectations are very, very different. As I was telling yesterday to both the students that if a policeman does something wrong in the society, do you accept it?
No, sir.
Yes or no?
No, sir.
Why? He is also a human being. Sometimes he behaves like a normal human. But the moment you come to know that he's a police guy, your expectation changed. No, he should not have done it because he's protecting our society. The same is the expectation from HR. The people talk about HR. HR is a solution provider. People look that he should not do anything wrong. He has to be in a very different understanding of people. So until unless you do not have that sensitivity about people. The second is, the most important, you need to partner yourself. Those days have gone, because everything will be on, as I said, to the IT and all. Your payroll works through that, PMS nowadays works through that, everything works through. But then you have to partner with sometimes with the marketing guys, sometimes with the technology people. You have to retain people, you have to understand their requirements, and you have to provide them solutions. You have to understand the facility management, what type of people expectations. HR is a brand ambassador. Now, I'll give you an example. When a recruitment takes place, an external world person who comes into the organization, he is the first single point of contact. And the way he experiences him, till the person joins, that creates a brand about an organization. Whether he has been interviewed the way it should have been interviewed, whether he was engaged in the interview, whether the commitment what was given to him, was he transparent in terms of his negotiations. Every step takes its own importance. And the moment he gets into that, he becomes a partner to them. The things start evolving. Because today, if you talk about IT, another word, the facility management has become a very important role. How the facilities are there? Are they able to get the way they want to work? Because working culture in manufacturing and that service industry is too different. So are they able to get them the way what they are looking for? Those days have gone that company is doing something different. You can evolve your own system. You can evolve your own. Let me tell you one thing. Products can be copied. Pricing can be copied. Processes can be copied. All these three things can be copied. But culture cannot be copied. It evolves. It evolves with a time basically. Today, if you talk about, I'll give you an example of the Indian culture. In spite of India having so many of the different castes, more than 200, they say the castes, religions are there, different religions are there. But why there is a unity in diversity? Can anybody tell me? The reason is, our culture has been developed in a manner that our fabric is so strong that we cannot get disconnected. I'll give you a simple example. When you talk about the Western culture, you talk about Mother Day, Father Day, Friends Day, and so many days. I know that you're talking about Valentine's Day. Okay. But when you talk about the Indian culture, it is already there. You have a friends festival, which is called your Holi. You have got a wife, husband, you call it, no? There is a Eid, and there is another one, Karwa Chauth, like that. Then you have brothers, sisters. Then you have family function, Diwali and the Ganesh Puja and all that, Onam and all that. Or Eid. So it is already there. So we are so imbibed, we are so knitted within our own selves that when our marriages happens, there is a bhaat which comes from the maternal uncle. There are so many, our social network has been created in such a strong manner. You can never have, in spite of so many differences, but still we people are united. And that's what we call it, the fabric of this country, which was evolved thousands of years. Think about those people, how intelligent or how what wisdom they were carrying at the time. And that's where, so what I was saying about the culture in any corporate or any institution. Today everybody talks about Tata culture. I think everybody is aware of it.
Yes, sir.
Tatas don't pay very well. Still people want to join them. Why?
Culture.
They are working because you have seen them for years and years. They have been, they incorporate half of the, if you talk, go to the HR, half of the laws were incorporated before the laws were made officially. You talk about CSR. So they were ahead of the time, basically. So they have evolved a culture where everybody would love to join to those companies. So every organization develops its own culture. And once you are able to develop your own culture, it takes time. I'm not saying it just evolves within a day or not. And that's the role, one of the core roles is with HR. How much he is engaged, how much he is transparent, how much the policies are. I'll give you an example of transformation. And when I was working with the Ramaya company, our company was a manufacturing, it used to be Tata Culture, Tata Telecom, it became Tata Lucent, and then it became Tata Wire, basically. It came from manufacturing, it went into the service industry, and then it became a matrix organization where every person was on a variable pay. In the sense, 10% to 35% of the salaries were variable pay. And there was so much of fear because we used to get 10 fixed salary and we started moving towards a variable pay. There was a lot of fear, psychosis, you know, what's going to happen. And the company from manufacturing going to service, how many people will be shunted out. Let me tell you one of the most important in any industry, any institution. It could be here also, it could be corporate, and it's your communication. It's a one-way traffic or a two-way traffic. Do you involve your people in getting what exactly is going into their minds? And that's what I saw in Avaya, that the way we engaged our people, the moment we went from manufacturing to we conducted more than, I think, 15 or 20 open houses. And I knew that in the open house, nobody wants to talk. They said, in the inception, I started asking, so nobody wanted to get up out of this 400. But at last, one or two people made up the courage to say something. Same happened there also. He said, okay. We gave them the slips. He said, you write whatever it is. Put them in a box. So it was not a good culture, but you had to, in the end of the day, you wanted to listen to the people, what is going in their mind, basically. And the first time when we did this open house with the people, and the second time, and the third time, and the fourth time, people became so used to, they should just get up. Because they never had a factor in their mind that, if I'm going to say something, the organization is going to take it negative. Because, let me tell you, everybody who is thinking something or the other has a reason behind it. Whatever the knowledge he carries, good or bad is not answer. The person who gets up first, his question may be the most silliest question. But let me tell you, he's the most bold person. Because he had the courage to get up and say, yes, this is my problem. So you had to evolve that culture. And Avaya also did the same thing. We created transparency within the organization. And every month, one leader had, it was mandatory for one leader to interact with all the people in the company. On the chat, on the video conferencing, whatever the mechanism we had kept. The reason was there has to be two-way traffic. There has to be listening polls in the organization. If you don't listen to the people in the organization, you'll not be able to evolve the right culture, basically. So once you're able to create that, so automatically what happens is the people start respecting you, people start believing you, people know that here is a company. You give them enough of space, you are engaging them. Let me tell you, when you go to the surveys, in the most of the surveys is written that hardly 30 to 40%, maybe even less than that, people are engaged in the organization. Because they don't love their jobs. They're not fully in the organization. They come there just to earn, to complete their day. And then what happens is they are under stress. And the whole day, they're not able to give them the productivity what they are expected to give. So one of the important role for HR person, I personally feel, is He has to understand people. He has to get himself in. He is not to be on a seat, basically. He is a solution provider, basically. HR is not a person who has to sit and he has to command from. It used to happen almost like 3-4 decades back when there used to be a personal department. Then it became an HR department. HR department means there is a policies and process. Earlier, personal department didn't have a policy. And there used to be two answers when I started my career. There's a word of policy. So the show me the face and tell you the policy. Or there were organizations, when you used to ask them, what's the policy, they used to say, we have a policy, not to have a policy. Written on policy. Then it came a period where HR came that you have a documented everything. Then it evolved further, it became like a partnering with them. Today, you're not to be only partnering, you have to provide them the solution. Today, if you go to, I think a lot of boys must be doing marketing also here.
Yes, sir.
Tell me, if you keep yourself in the customer show, are you ready to listen to the company if you have a problem?
Yes.
You want it on yesterday basis answer, solution? That's what we expect. And that's what people in the organization will expect from the HR person. They have to understand. People have to be. So until unless you don't acquire knowledge, you don't acquire what's going in the industry, what's going into the corporate world, what's going into the best of the practices. He has to keep himself acknowledged. He has to engage with the people through the different rewards and recognition schemes. He has to evolve schemes for not, like what happens in the corporate world, the mandates decided. These many mandates of training has to be provided. They conduct the training, but what's going to be the outcome of the training is not. But the way the things are moving, because everything, there is a cost to it. In the end of the day, you have to give an ROI. The HR people, HR analytics, they need to be very good at HR analytics. And everybody is today talking about the big data, big data, big data. What big data is all about? Because everything is being put into the figures, basically. We need to evolve policies and processes looking into what the feedback coming. So the most important you people need to learn is that, first of all, in the inception I told you that you have to make your base very strong. And base can only happen through 3 or 4 things. The number one, which is the most important, how strong you are into your personal value system. And values are like, what's your attitude towards it? Do you start with a problem or do you start with a solution? Do you acquire knowledge? Learning has no shortcut. Let me tell you, if you don't learn, learning is not reading books. Learning is not going to the Google. Learning can happen by interacting also, by viewing also, what's happening in and around. Reading a newspaper. We don't invest in terms of learning. So until your foundations are not good, and the most and most important, let me tell you what I have learned out of my life is discipline. A discipline doesn't mean that 8 o'clock if you are committed, you have to reach to the office at 8:30 and 9:05. That's not discipline. Discipline means much. Discipline and honesty means very, very different. To me, I understand these two things are very, very different. Honesty means once you are saying something to you, are you really meaning that or not? That's honesty is all about. You stand to yourself or not? Are you honest within your own self or not? In your commitments, in your statements, in your doings? That's honesty is all about. Honesty is not for the external world that you're not paid a bribe to somebody. It's not honesty. It's just a part of it. But real honesty lies within your own self. Real discipline lies within your own self. You call somebody at 3 o'clock in the evening, and you, because you are the top guy, you reach at 5 o'clock, as the political leader does it. Is that leadership is all about? It's not that. In the corporate world, it doesn't work, basically. And that's where you develop your trust. Let me tell you, people respect you through basic fundamentals. How you are talking, how you are behaving, how you are interacting with them, how you are committed to them. automatically, you do not know, today also I think a lot of professors might not be teaching you here. But you know about them. How do you know about them? And the same happens in the industry, in the corporate also. People start knowing you through your actions. Here is a person who is a self-driven. You need not have to... Let me tell you, self-motivation is the only motivation in the world. Don't wait, somebody is going to pat you. If you get, fine. You have done something good, yes, people should say good about you. And these are the basic fundamentals what I am telling you. Because rest of the things what I am going to tell you about the digitalization happens, or PMS happens, and talent management has taken a very different role itself. Today everything is on LinkedIn. You can, a time is going to come where you will be mapped in terms of your capabilities on the net itself. At what level you are. Your antecedent, everything will be happened through the system itself. Like, once it is, you have been verified, it's available there. It will come out of the database. So what the HR guy is going to do? He has to involve himself. He has to understand how the industry is moving. He has to see what the people are expecting. Do they have fear? Or if the technology is changing, is he providing them a platform where he is able to give them a learning, adapt to something else so that they can go into the different task itself. Things are going to be very different, as I said. Offices will go away. The boundaries have already, the Berlin walls have already fallen. So things will not be the way you think. There's not going to be statement answers for everything. Whatever I'm telling you, half of the things may not have required also. But let me tell you, the fundamentals will be required. The fundamentals have been there for centuries and will require. Do you know, have you heard about marathon race?
Yes, sir.
How many kilometers it is?
10, 21, 12, 24.
You know, everybody started whispering on who they were. Okay, 42, 48, 45, 46. Somebody gets up and doesn't know that that's given one answer. Nobody asks you whether it is right or wrong. Because you have no right to say she is wrong because you didn't reply to it. Does it get up, no? I know, I listened to you earlier also. It's 42 kilometers, it's 27 miles approximately 42 kilometers. And let me tell you what it means to you. You are running a marathon race. You are running a... I think these people are not running, only these people are running. Are you running?
Yes, sir.
What are you running?
Marathon.
What does it mean? Okay, now I'll give you the... Why I said about your marathon race, you are at age of 20, 22. On an average. Somebody is smiling, you say that no, I'm more than that, but still let you say 22 is fine with me. Okay. So at the age of 22, when you start your career, you have another 42 years of your career. Somewhere about 60, 65. Probably at your age, it may be 50, 55. But in today's, the way I look, it's a marathon race you people are running. Let me tell you, if I ask you another question to you, a lot of boys have joined the corporate world. The first thing when they join different corporate, what do they exchange from in terms of when they meet each other, what do they ask each other? What do they ask? The moment new person joins in corporate, he gets a job, and they all meet together. The first thing, what did they ask from each other?
Introduction.
They don't talk about the salaries. The first thing, probably because you are You get from the campus, so you know each other's salary. The first thing they try to know from each other, what package you got it. Right or wrong? And very few people ask me what type of position. And second question comes, what position you got it? You say, I got this position like me. And very few people ask, oh, what's your boss? Okay, then you don't interact with him. You don't know really your boss. And very few people out of them ask about what job content you're working on. Let me tell you why I set up a marathon. Because the first 5 years of your career are the most important. The more you acquire knowledge, you being in an HR or a marketing or whatever it is, the first 5 years are going to be very, very important to you. The more you learn, if you're into an HR, you should know the completely cycle of the HR. Whether you are working in a payroll division or talent department or wherever you are. But you need to understand how does the total cycle, HR cycle works. Same is the marketing. Marketing person has to understand right from product, how the product is created, how the market is created, how the selling takes place, what are the customer expectations, and how does it goes down back. For the feedback and how you improve your sales and market penetration or market portion. You need to understand these things. So the moment you start learning this, first 5 years why I said that, let me tell you, if you have seen marathon race, the first 5 to 7 kilometers or 10 kilometers, the best runner and the worst runner, they are almost on a very close distance. There's not much of a difference. So probably you may also not find much of a difference in terms of salary, positions and all. But after that, the gap starts. And there the difference starts. And that all depends on what knowledge you carry with you. How strong is your foundation? How you are able to take up yourself to that level, basically. How big you are able to build up your stories onto it. You need to understand that. So knowledge has no second. Learning has no second thought about it. Learning doesn't mean that you pick up a book and you start reading it every day. No, learning can happen anytime. You should have attitude to learn in the sense that whatever you see something new happening in the world, why it happens. And in the Japanese context, I'll tell you there are three things which they do the maximum like it. And which is the most important. The number one, they always have why. They say why. Why it's happening? They question everything. The moment you know the why, automatically you get the answer of it. And then the second process is how it is to be corrected. And once you are able to correct it, and then you set that process, and you repeat time and again, repeatability. As somebody said in the morning, that they believe in the Kaizen. What is Kaizen basically?
Continuous improvement.
Idea. Continuous improvement. What exactly it is?
Keep on improving.
It's innovation. What exactly it is? You know, you people have read it. I know that some people might have read it, some people might have worked or gone as an intern into the automobile world. So everybody has his own. But let me tell you, when I look back, I did my personal research on it, it keeps you thinking to do something new, to do something better. It evolves a process in your mind to do something more, to do something better. And that's Kaizen. Kaizen, what you say, improvement is an outcome of it. But ultimately, in the stage, it evolves you to think for a betterment. So your attitude automatically develops to do something new, to do something better. The difference between, let me tell you, Kaizen and innovation. Innovation, a lot of inputs in terms of cost, resources goes into. While in Kaizen, it's a small resources they do. They don't spend money on it, basically. Small money they may spend But they don't know. But innovation, there's a huge of research happens. It takes years and years. That's the difference. Innovation is a word from the Western side, and the Kaizen is a word from the Eastern world. Then they talk about the quality circles. What is quality circles? And again, the system is very simple. You come together for a particular problem, you try to resolve that problem, try to work it out, that, and improve on it. And that's done in a team way, basically. Kaizen could be individual, Kaizen could be one or two people together. But generally, in quality circles, you develop a project and you start working on it. That's where the team work starts. It's a building of team. So you need, the moment you go to the industry or you go to the corporate world, but let me tell you, manufacturing has its own process, and IT or service industry has its own process. You want to see a corporate type of world, a white collar world, so probably service industry maybe. But when you go to the manufacturing, but manufacturing, the beauty of manufacturing is ultimately you can see the things happening there. In the service industry, you don't see the things happening. If you're a people-oriented person, I think service is a good. But if you want to evolve something, you want to do something new, or something you want to improve on, then manufacturing is. So each has its own advantages. So where you want to go, you need to learn on your own what you like, what you don't like. And the most important, last but not the least, because I'd like to ask different questions from the different people. One thing you people should always remember, success has no shortcuts, and success is within you only. If you're disciplined about yourself, if you are, you love yourself, if you evolve yourself. Let me tell you one thing to all of you people. Please be that you people all are unique people. Do you resemble to each other?
No, sir.
Do you have the same thought process?
No, sir.
When you don't have, you yourself has a difference. So why you don't evolve? In the morning I was telling to Mansi that you need to have your USP, so she said some other jargon. What was it? POD. I said, I don't know, but I think the meaning same should be same. So you need to develop that. You have something unique within yourself. Love yourself, do that, rather than following somebody else, basically. And as in the inception itself, I said that, take one thing which you adopt. And I was telling about the Mahabharata. Arjun had knew how to use all the weapons, but he did mastery on one. And he evolved himself, the whole world knows him for the archivist. So you have to. Now somebody will laugh onto it, like I say, everybody can't be an Arjun here. But let me tell you, in some place you can be Arjun of your own self. You need to be unique, you need to be different, you need to be. And let me tell you, and I give an example of Newton, basically. So before Newton asked why the apple comes down, usse pehle ke apple upar jata tha, kahan jata tha? Niche jata tha. When he started asking, what the people said to him, you're one man. So in this world, let me tell you, I see within my own life also, the moment you start crossing, you're asking people, why it happened this way? Your people, your friends, within your family also, I think is gone mad. You look at your own job. Because everybody love to go into a path which is a comfort zone. So if you people want to grow, if you people want to evolve yourself, you have to leave your comfort zone. And let me tell you, the day that you cross that comfort zone, everything is comfortable. Everything is comfortable. Because you always have that fear of crossing that comfort. And once you are able to, then you say, oh, it was not difficult. Yeah. request to all your people that whatever the learnings you are making, do practice and do make them actionable. And nobody is able to make you successful until you decide. And before cheating the whole world, let me tell you, you need to cheat yourself. And these are the basic fundamentals I always believe, and which made me to reach to this level. And as I was saying that, my eyes to go before I sleep, which I learned long back, I get to go a big journey, and which I'm trying to evolve. If 30% of my career has finished, that's 70% I look for the next 5 years. And that's the passion what I live with, that's the passion what I believe in, that's the passion I always commit to. Now I'll ask you if you have any questions. Yes, ma'am. You know why I use the word, in fact, I'm saying that this word ma'am, my father was in the army, and what I learned in the army was, whenever any function used to happen, and the family used to come, the first and the foremost, which...
Every organization is trying to deliver their employees best of the best service. They are, whether you talk about transparency or whether you talk about benefits and all. But in every organization, the employees also complaining. If you see the Glassdoor reviews and all about what the employee feel about the organization, you will find the positive as well as the negative comments from that. So, if every organization is trying to do their best and still the employees are complaining, how each organization creating a difference that this is the best organization or this is not a good organization?
Okay. Few things I'll always, number one, the existence of good is the bad one. There's nothing like good, there's nothing like bad. It's not philosophy, that's a fact. If you enjoy something, there is a pain, that's why you enjoy. Other it's all normal. First thing you enjoy. The second thing, what you rightly said, on the dark door or many of the other social media, you find, yes, there's a big challenge. There's a big challenge. And who are responsible for it is we people. Is we people. Who are running these organizations? Is it being run through the money only? No. It's the leaders. So what culture they're evolving in their organization? In the morning I was sharing something. The real leader, if you talk about to me, I read about it and I liked it. I think you might have also seen it. And how, whether you paid that attention to that or not on the website. He defined that the real leadership is all about who makes the company grow. But when it comes to the rainy days, you should not cut down on people. And he brought a very different mechanism than, like there are about 1,000 people and about 100 people got away. Given a pink letter. He said, no, I would not like to give. So that's not leadership what I've learned about it. If I have to do that, I'm not a right leader. So he evolved a very different thought process. He said, if the pain is there, why only these 100 people to be at this pain? Why not all the 1,000 people? Let's share the pain of it. And he said, let every person go for 1 month or 2 months of unpaid leave. By cycling. So in the end of the day, what happens? You're reducing your resources in terms of expenses, basically. And that's the way he thought of, and that's the way they practiced it. And that's what leadership is all about. And he even gave them the flexibility, if somebody wants to go for 3 months, he can buy from somebody else. So let the person work in place, and you can go for 3 months. So that's the kind of flexibility. But they did not give the things that are. That's a very different way of thinking. That's the way that organizations need to think. But you have to rise above the level to that. It's very easy to preach. And when I was in seventh, I learned in Ashoka's chapter that before preaching the whole world, you need to preach yourself. So until as you yourself don't, I think there is a saying of Dayananda Saraswati that he said somebody not to take salt.
said, no, no, don't go. He tackled for 15 days. He said, yes, it can happen. Then he said to that person, okay, now you should not take salt. And that's good for your health. So that's the way. The real leaders are those only. Making policies, strategies, these are all fine weapons. But in the end of the day, are you people engaging your own people or not? And I'm telling the difference between the engagement and bonding. There is a bonding which is required in them. If you really want to create a culture, you have to create a bonding rather than. And for bonding, you're ready to do and die, as the defense guy does. Does he work for compensation then? So what? He? When you ask this guy, they say, my regiment is going to get the name and fame. My regiment is having 50 medals of Paramveer, Research Noida, Research Medal. He is so much engrossed into his own organization. We talk about the infantry regiment, the way they talk about it. They do and die for the regiments. That's what we do. In the social world, I know that it doesn't happen. Yes, if you engage your people completely. Let me tell you, if you are fully engaged, you'll never have a stress. Stress comes to those people who are enough to think about it. And when you're not engaged, so you need to learn to love your profession. Be in a profession where you love it. You enjoy your profession. You never have a stress. You never need anybody's motivation. You will create your own motivation within your own self. I'll give you a simple example. Suppose you're working in an industry, and at 12 o'clock midnight, December 31st, the boss telephones you, look, guy, you have to come immediately because the machine is down and they have to give the production to the morning. How would you look like? Or not 31st December, it could be any 22nd December. It's a very, temperature is minus 4. And you don't have proper woolen clothes. I'm talking about Northern India. What will happen? Will you feel good or bad? Bad. Because you're not engaged. Or you feel winter water. Okay, you're ready to go. But you feel very shivering like that. You not feel comfortable. And if this same happens, your parents are going to come or your girlfriend is going to ask you to come at 12 o'clock at the same time. And you don't have even a... And if you, what will happen? Will you feel the winter?
No.
Pardon?
No, sir.
Why are you trying to say no?
No, sir.
So dear friends, it's all situation, it's all mindset. Your passion, your love, everything lies here. What's your belief system? So, create something within your own self. And read. There is enough to read. You can, while walking also you can read about it. You can sing also you can read about it. How much you are good. It doesn't mean you need to be serious. But you need to be different. You need to be like that. What is your purpose of life? Do you know about it? What do you want to be? I'll give you an example of myself. One of the things which I dive within myself was, I wanted to make my parents proud of me. When they move in the social then network, they feel that my son is at that position. They have that different kind of, and probably that was where I thought that I was able to enhance their 10 years life. That was the objective. So if your purpose is not about you, how can you be successful? You need to create that success. You may have a lot of challenges. We have also gone through, let me tell you, you people have started with a bike or four-wheeler. But when we started, even we didn't have a cycle also. So we don't give. When we got in the first industry, I still remember, we got a water cooler. We celebrated it. Things were very different. It doesn't mean that you need to also have that. No, but what I'm trying to say, you need to celebrate each of your, what are the moments. Don't look at somebody else. Don't look at it. In the corporate world, there will be enough of challenge. But let me tell you how firm you are within your foundations. How good you are at knowledge. How much you have learned adaptability, flexibility within your own self. Rest everything strategies can be made. As I said, that everything can be made, but you yourself cannot be made. Don't get yourself flow in the river. Live a life rather than flow in the life. That's my one of the message what I would like to give.
Thank you, sir. That was the last question for the day.
In the last, I'd say two of the things. Only one thing which I'd like to do. Ek mein share kar dunga. Acha lagega. Rishad pehle se hi keh diya. Aapne ek share suna hoga. खुदी को कर बुलंद इतना की हर तहरीर से पहले खुद अपने बंदे से खुद ऊंचे की चेकिंग लगा के आई नो माय पापा
स्टिल
गेट ये दो शेर थे जो कि हमारी फादर जी ने दिए आई थिंक आई माइट बी इन सेवन डे टू नाइन क्लास एंड प्रॉबली द सेकंड दो आपने इसके जुड़वा शेर भी सुना होगा विच इज द अटमोस्ट It is the utmost. And that's life is all about. And that's the journey we need to know. Mita de apni hasti ko. Mita de apni hasti ko. Agar kuch martaba chahe ki dana khaak mein milke gure guzar ho.
Thank you, sir. With the words of wisdom, we believe that self-belief system and respect for a nation will definitely take us much ahead in life. Your insights into different industries and profile has certainly thrown more light into our understanding of corporate world. The attitude to learn always is the key to success. Thank you once again.